There we go.
Thanks very much.
Sure. Okay. Okay, everybody's organised? Good, thank you. I have decided that at 10 a.m. Monday morning, a ballot for the Labor leadership will be conducted. Following Kevin Rudd's resignation yesterday, I have formed this view that we need a leadership ballot in order to settle this question once and for all. I believe it is in the interests of the Labor Party that it be determined once and for all, but much more importantly, I believe it is in the interests of the Australian nation. For far too long, we have seen squabbling within the Labor Party, which has obscured the government's achievements and what we are doing to build a stronger and fairer Australia for the future. In recent days, I believe that this has moved to a distraction from governing itself. That's not good enough. Australians are rightly sick of this and they want it brought to an end. Only Labor can provide the vision that this country needs for our future, and Labor can only provide it if we resolve this issue once and for all and proceed with unity and determination. When the ballot is called at 10 a.m. on Monday morning, I will re-nominate for the Labor leadership, and I expect to receive the support of my colleagues when I do so. But let me be very clear about this. If, against my expectation, I do not receive the support of my colleagues, then I will go to the backbench and I will renounce any further ambition for the Labor leadership. This would be in the best interests of the government and the nation. I anticipate that Mr. Rudd will also be a candidate in this ballot. I ask him to give the same undertaking, that if he does not succeed in this ballot, that he will go to the backbench and renounce any further claims to the leadership and act in the interests of the Australian Labor Party and of our nation. In the past 18 months under my leadership, the government has secured some major reforms which will make us a stronger and fairer nation in the future. It will make us ready for the future. In these reforms, I'm thinking of the reform we have introduced to put a price on carbon and to seize a clean energy future for us. A reform that I have delivered in this minority government parliament. A reform that was not possible prior to my leadership, despite the support of the then leader of the opposition for a price on carbon and despite the same leader of the Greens being in the federal parliament. Under my leadership, we have also enacted a minerals resource rent tax to better share the mineral wealth within our grounds and to back in important changes like more superannuation for Australian workers and better arrangements to support small business. When I became leader of the Labor Party, this reform was the subject of a vicious national debate and there was no prospect that it was going to be secured. Thirdly, under my leadership, we have secured an historic health agreement right around the nation that is meaning more doctors, more nurses, and more local control of hospitals. It's meaning less emergency department waiting time. It's meaning better access to elective surgery. When I became Prime Minister, there was an agreement which did not extend to every corner of the nation and which was being picked apart by premiers and was not going to stand the test of time. Under my leadership too, we have secured the structural separation of Telstra, what we needed to do in order to back in the rollout of the national broadband network. This was a reform not attempted before I came to the Prime Ministership, but a vital reform for the nation's future. In addition, under my leadership, we have secured the means testing of the private health insurance rebate, a fairness measure, fairer to low and middle income earners who are no longer going to be asked to subsidise the private health insurance of those who earn so much more than they do. Once again, prior to me becoming Prime Minister, this reform had been attempted, but it had not been secured. In this minority parliament, I have secured it. And of course, as Prime Minister, I have continued to roll out the education reforms that I designed, and we are in the process of adding to them, because there is nothing more important to our nation's future than making sure that every child goes to a great school and gets a great education. At the same time, as we have done all of this, under my leadership, we have ensured that low-income workers get a fairer tax deal. We have taken the steps necessary to get the budget on the track back to surplus, and we will deliver that surplus in 2012-13. And we have continued to manage the Australian economy so that it is strong and offers Australians the benefit of jobs. Jobs today, whilst we build the new economy we will need for the jobs of tomorrow. Now, no government is perfect, and I have made mistakes over the past 18 months. I acknowledge that. But ultimately, the measure of a government is what the government achieves for the Australian people, what meaningful change and meaningful reforms are delivered. The measure of a government is not by opinion polls or daily headlines in newspapers. I believe that the driving purpose of a Labor government is to make sure our nation is stronger and fairer in the future than it is today. Achieving that vision requires us to make all of the right choices today, to manage the economy in the interests of working people, whilst we make the right choices to build for the future, so that in that future people will have the opportunity to get a job, get a better job, start their own small business if they choose to. Families will have the security that they need to nurture their children and to know that they will have a great future. That is the driving purpose and ambition of a Labor government, to meet the needs of working people today and tomorrow. Ultimately, under my leadership, I believe we have been securing the big reforms that will make us stronger and fairer. But we've got so much more work to do building on those reforms. So much more work to do to make sure that every child does go to that great school, which is why we are now pursuing the work flowing from the major review of school funding and new proposals to empower school principals so that they can run their schools knowing that they can give every child a great education. But the reforms we still have to pursue to make sure that Australian adults have the skills they need to get the job they want, which is why I am taking a major skills reform package to COAG in April. The reforms that we need as a nation to make sure that in this time of structural adjustment and change, we continue to be a nation that has got the benefit of a diversified economy, that we don't just have one source of strength, the resources boom, but we have many sources of strength, including the manufacturing sector, tourism, international education, and a services economy. We've got more to do to make sure that Australians who live a life with a disability or the people who care for those Australians with that disability get a fair go and a fair chance. We've got more to do to make sure, as our society ages, that we are supporting older Australians and giving them the choices and options they need and deserve. It's my intention to seek the support of my Labor colleagues to make sure that I can continue to pursue this reform agenda as Prime Minister. Meaningful reforms that will have an impact on Australian families and better support them in their lives and better give them economic opportunities for the future. Now, I note that Kevin Rudd, in his media statements yesterday and today, has very consistently referred to the need to defeat Tony Abbott at the next election. I want to be clear about this too. I believe that we can win the next election and defeat Tony Abbott. I believe I can lead Labor to that victory, provided that the Labor Party unites and we get on with the job. But I also want to be very clear about this. Government is about more than electioneering. Government is about having the courage to get the big reforms done. Government is about making sure that each and every day you have the discipline and the method necessary to get the huge volume of work done that government needs to do. Government is about having the personal strength in adversity to still ensure that you stay focused and you get your job done. I believe I have demonstrated those attributes as Prime Minister, the courage on the big reforms, the discipline and method to make every day count, the personal sense of strength, which means that I can always keep going no matter how adverse the circumstances. In this Labor leadership ballot, I will be saying to my colleagues that we need to come together and to keep working in the interests of the Australian people each and every day, delivering the big reforms that are always the hallmarks of Labor governments.